Okay, so first things first, we're going to split up the model Vulkan stuff out to a set into the graphics library. So what I already have here is like image, and imagine back here somewhere I have like image upload. Or is it this? Upload data, submit upload data. Okay. Not exactly great, but mesh model data. Let's see what we got here. First things we've got is allocating the buffers. Then we've got mapping the buffers. We've got unmapping them. Let me pull this in. All this, and that's basically it. So, okay, need to bring in all that. That brings that stuff in. I'll need to export these actually while I'm here as well. Okay. Yeah, okay. So So at the moment we are doing shared objects, right? Yeah. Let's fix this while we're here. Okay, we've got model, and model for the photographic section. Now, animation, this is an interesting one because this is a blend of graphic stuff and uses model stuff specifically, right? Or it's almost exclusively graphics. Oh no, yeah, there is the model stuff. I'm not entirely sure how I'm going to combine them quite yet. Because I'm not entirely sure how I'm going to extract this stuff either. Because right now, I don't like the idea of having like graphics just be exclusively tied to Vulkan here. I'd probably want to have like a in kind of a layer below an interface, if you will. But at the moment, I'm not entirely sure how to do that quite yet. Quite yet. Sooner or later. All right. Yeah. Okay. Okay, let's get the model stuff in. Added basic model. Functionality. Okay. What else we want to rip out? How it loads the model, maybe? The animation. Okay, we'll put the rest of this in here for the moment. Temp. Okay, and we'll switch back to models. We'll put this up, we'll check how that builds, and then we'll merge that in, then we'll work on the rest. Alright, let's see what we got. We got an error on the Windows one. Of course. Error, space, void, cannot convert argument 1 from const path to const char. Yes. File system. File importer plugins. CPP. Whoop. Line 23. This. It's right. On Unix, this converts to const char star, but C string on Windows does not. If I do that, though, that should work. As backwards as that is. Let's see how that turns out. Bam. And let's see what came through. It looks like. Okay, that looks. Okay, that passed. See, the messages are good. Yes. Yeah. Functionality. Okay. Okay. Basis on the main. Okay. Okay, so this is what we have at the moment. We're doing 12 minutes. Okay. Okay, something I really need to do then is to figure out how to bring models and images and textures in, really. And armatures and animations. A whole bunch of things. Because right now, it's all manual. I'm just manually instigating it all. I really need a system. Especially for animations and armatures. I really don't want to have to do it all manually. Okay, maybe not. For the moment, perhaps, what I should do is look towards... Okay, what can I do in the meantime? I can probably do, like, automatic creation of like a box model or a sphere model while I think about the more interesting stuff, or cube I should say, rather than a box. Yeah. Okay, so if we go to here, we can do this file importer, cube importer, cube for the moment anyways. So it'll be based on that. We got a class that's going to, of course, go through all the functions. No armature, no animation. Yeah, okay. Crap. Okay. Maybe not then. Or okay, I'm not entirely okay, whatever. We'll focus down on like three functions. It'll be like cube vertex data. And then like this. We'll of course still take opponent count and data like that. Nope, let's just include. Of course, we're going to need a bunch of cube data, which I'm not quite sure. There's 16 of them. We'll need a pull in an array. Not 16. Jeez. So it'll be like 32 times. Oh, sorry, 36. Times 1, 2, 3. Right? Yeah. So it'll be like 108. Expression. There we go. Okay, I'll get the data to fill these in later. And wait, no, I need two others. So it'll be 36 by 2. Indices. Okay, then we'll have these functions, which be like the offset. Same thing here. Okay. Okay. Okay, we go through, we'll have, okay, what I can do for the indices is, I can do a template function. Send vector? No. Index type, offset. Like this. We can do. Go through all of these and we just add it, put it in. So like star p data plus equals it's going through these guys, so this guy is moving up correctly. So it's c cube indice, or rather it's just iterator plus offset. Then it's just cube index data times 16 type offset and p data. Now, for the vertex data, not quite so easy. key, for God's sakes. Auto, because this could be a float or a double, or I don't know. There's still not really a good float 16, is there? Half float. Okay, is there like an Okay, no. I'll just assume it's a float then. Or yes, I will not. I will do a template. So we have 32T. Okay, basically we need to pass these guys in like this. We already have the data, or actually I should say it's a T type. So do I go with, I'm going to assume that you're talking about a full block. So we're going per vertex. Vertex equals 0, and p is less than c num cube vertices. Okay, and then we got to go through all the components. So 4, 32t, c is less than component count. Just switch for p component. We'll do similar to what we got in down here, I believe. Yes, except this will be different, wouldn't it? No, because it's yeah, okay, no, it's not quite going to work. Okay, case. Actually, I would want to keep at least the cases. So we got these. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's no color type. So, and if we have color, then we're going to have to do something. We're just going to have to, like, abort. Because I don't actually have any color things I can return with a cube. Beyond, like, putting white or black or some other color. It doesn't really matter. Really, using color for this type is just, it's wrong. It's super wrong. Whatever. P data Vertex times 3 plus 0. It'll be like this. 1, 2, 3. It'll break. Alright. It's the same thing, but for normal. 2 times for UV. 3 times for tangent, 3 times for bitangent. Okay. Whoops. So this is times 2 for UV. Tangent. By tangent. Okay. Anything I really want to return with otherwise? I don't think so. I just fill it up with the data and then I leave. Okay. All right. I'll just pause and go offline and get all this data filled up. All right. So I got all that in. Position, normal, tangent by tangent, UV locations, and finally this. So we build this. It's going to error out from standard abort because I don't actually have that existing in here. Rather, we're going to pull that in instead. And we're going to like, which does actually have it. Okay, let's add a log jest for this. Okay, let's get the log, graphics log, model log. Model all. Okay, let's grab this CPP. What's required in there? It's just this. Okay, new category defined, great. tried to generate. Okay. Okay, one thing I want to try then is to actually display this cube by itself. So what I need to do, first of all, I need to not, okay. Yeah, great. We don't want a boned one, just want a regular one. Okay, we don't have these other attributes. Only have the first set. One and two. Okay. Close all these. Simplify back down to just engine. Okay, allocating buffers and stuff, blah, 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 blah. Okay, what I want is, I don't even really want normal data. Actually, I do. Okay, add these, but I don't actually want to import the data quite like that. Okay. Basically, let's just kind of do this. Mesh and bones and what have you. Nope. Pointer, it's going to be a type float to do an array text data. Oh, it's size. Ah. So 36 times 3. There's 8 floats. Yeah. Okay, then we go cube vertex data, which is what components dot size. components.data and vertex data. Amazing. Components, great. Which is this. Zero. And vertex data size. Equals that. That is actually used elsewhere, I imagine. No index data here. So then this, and we come all the way down here. We no longer have the second vertex data to bind. It's just the first. That's it. It's also no secondary this. And no model matrix to bind either. This does nothing right now. I mean, they'll just put stuff in, but won't be used. Indices. Let's see if we have a cube or not. We do not. Because I'm not exporting the functions, first of all. Can become lost. Okay. Why am I here then? Do I have like an allocation of size 0 or something like that? I'm trying to work. What's going on? Yeah, okay, so in addition to the everything else I'm going to ignore, I'm also going to I'm gonna just like nuts to this. It all gets disabled for the moment. Amazing. Become lost because, well, at least it got down to here. So there's absolutely nothing here. Fantastic. Let's open render doc. Let's see what we get. Load last settings. Launch. Mesh viewer. Wonderful. On this one, what we got? Position, UV, are just, it's just all zeros. Terrible. Absolutely terrible. So the vertex buffer we're binding is 202. Let's have a look at the 202. It's just all zeros. Why is it all zeros? You tell me, computer. I couldn't have screwed up that badly, although I definitely probably did. So it's resized all the zeros, I presume. Yes. And afterwards, it's all zeros. It's entirely my fault. Classic. Yeah. Okay, I can see the problem now. Actually, oh no, because this is float, right? Yeah, I want to make sure this is a float type. What? Does not name a template. It's this one right here. Oh, okay, I see. It's void. No. What? Does this function not exist or something? Did I forget how to do template? I don't. Cube vertex data does not name a template but is followed by template arguments. Did you mean that? No! It just automatically went straight for this one. Can I just do this? Or is this just like a thing where it just goes into itself all the time? Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Whatever. All right. You get that? You're great. And now we've got a cube. That's great. We have a very basic cube that we can construct in 120 odd lines. For debugging, for any purpose really. Okay, actually, first of all, we'll add the model log. What the hell's going on here? General inside plugin. Okay, there's no actual model log otherwise inside here yet. But there will be. I almost guarantee it. So we'll take cube out for the moment. We can actually probably add that. Declaration and definition. Okay, simple enough. Then we add cube. Add cube, add cube, add cube. Probably actually want to like polish up cube a little bit more though. So that it follows a similar pattern as this. Or slightly better. Or rather, just model cube. Yeah. One, two, three. Okay. This literally just returns this value up here. And then this will be like int. Yeah, I actually may just want to stick with this pattern instead of having returning this or a vector every time. This vector presumes, because eventually I'm going to be wanting to do something where, because at the moment what I'm doing is obviously I'm just like getting the data in the CPU side, in RAM, and then I'm allocating buffers. Then I'm copying the data in. But what I may want to actually do is later on just like figure out how many I need to like the upload buffer size first, allocate it, map them, then just put the data, like put this data straight into them, and then leave. No intermediary buffers required. So I probably want to move on to that. And for that, I need to have like the number of these guys, which also simplifies the importer quite a bit, or it will, anyways. Number of vertices for. Okay. Do I actually have like this as, no, I don't actually have any explanation of this yet. Or even on the importer? No. I'll just add it here, I guess. Buffer, what's consolidated, squashed, merged, like a vector, what does it do? Contiguous. Contiguously. Be this times what, well, the stride of and this will be a component count in that. Time size of float size bytes. Okay. Okay. That's some better explanations. Going back to engine. Nah, I already know what this is. I'm good for this. Actually, as right now, components is actually giving returning the byte size based on floats, isn't it? It's always, yeah. Okay, make sure we still got a cube coming out of it. Oh, not quite. Great. It's a frickin' cube magic. Information. Okay. What about sphere? Sphere is another big one we'll want. I did put the right, yeah, fall, yeah. Basically the same thing, but for spheres. And we're going to have a value for int subdivision. Or recursion. Since I'm going to be like starting, so like each level of recursion will give finer detail on the sphere. So level 0 will be like almost a cube, I imagine. And then each level of recursion more, subdivide it more. Recursion or subdivision. I think I'll go with subdivision. So you have that. You have that. Same thing here. expense of exponential number of vertices. Bam. Just add that note to each one of these. Sphere, there it is. Pretty sure we're going to want to do something similar. So we'll get these at the bottom. Okay, this really means I need to figure out a sphere calculation to generate one from scratch. Okay, it's float stuff, so icosahedron. Looks best. UV sphere. Subdivided cube. Actually, that's true. An icosahedron is triangles, the rest are cubes. I'd probably prefer to use the ICO. Math. Okay, this looks pretty much what I'm looking for. Okay, so you start with a 12. Based on each axis, with T being this. Then you have five faces around each point. based on the index, the first 12 indices, okay. And you just kind of subdivide it up, and then you'll have to renormalize it. Middle point, okay, yeah, I see. The middle point of each of the three sides comes with three new indices. You take these, put it into the middle, put it in the middle, put it in the middle, then another triangle in the middle. Then you can probably renormalize these to shrink it or increase it just enough to add a bit of smoothness to the sphere. Once, twice, and three times, yeah. Okay, I don't like the fact that it's just generating a crap ton of new literal objects everywhere. I probably want to do this in memory as much as possible. And this is C sharp. Okay. Tenure. Oh, this is an old thing. Okay. Okay. Starting with creation of the original part. Let's move this over here. Okay. Icosphere. Let's change this to icosphere. Icosphere.cpp. Whoops. Bam, icospheres all over the place. Cube becomes icos. Yeah, I don't know how exactly I'm going to approach this one yet. Okay. So this will actually be recursion instead of subdivision. Okay, we'll use GLM for this. Need two sets of data. And faces, okay. To start with, total starting points and the faces start at 20. I'm not entirely sure what this is about. I'll figure it out in a moment. We've got the distance, then we have to add vertices. What does he do in that vertex? Like, why is it different from this? Okay, those are phase. Those are just being added. So he's doing something special here. Okay. Where is this? There it is. He's just normalizing it. Okay. Vec 3 of negative 1. Two, three, four. So one, and then these are negative. In this case, distance is last. Zero first, that, and then distance. Negative and negative, positive, positive. Then distance becomes first. With 0 being the middle value, and 1 being the last one. Positive, positive, negative, negative. Base 20 triangles. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Adjacent. That looks better. Point 3, and then the 5 adjacent faces. Right. So it's just okay. Sorry, faces dot place back. Okay, I'll be back in a moment when I freaking do this. Okay. Okay, next we have to go through refining the icosphere, which is this little shindy going on. Based on the number of recursion levels, we add new faces. For each face, we go in, we add the new faces, including the original face, and then set it back. Okay. Well, he does in C sharp. Let's see if I can do it better. Triangles. Because those new faces, actually, that's true. I'm thinking he, oh, come on. Why can I not move it? There we go. Even though, like, in isolation, this looks simple enough, the problem is that this new point is also going to be used by whatever triangles adjacent to this one as well. So this, I need a cache, which I imagine is what get middle point probably does. Probably got like a cache hiding around somewhere. Yeah, he's got this cache that would get middle point, probably checks. Yeah, and then if he doesn't have it, then he calculates a new one. Okay, so we're going to need some kind of cache for this, for sure. Can I just use a map? Probably a tuple, looks like. These first two, this tuple is between the two points, the two original points on the edge. And then this other value is the new middle point between the two. So what I'm going to do is I am going to basically do that, I guess. Can I just add it to the very end? I could just add these to the end. As long as I get the... No, I can't. No, yes, I can. Yes, I can. Faces.reserve. Faces... dot size times 4, because it's going to increase by a factor of, well, 4 basically. Or for every point, there's going to be an extra 3 triangles coming out of it. So 1 triangle to 4 triangles. So I need to times it by 4. Then I can just add these new guys to the very end and just keep the original in there as it is already. Although it's not going to be as nice. Of a triangle list, I guess. I'm not too concerned about that right now. So, interfaces. End triangle equals whatever the faces dot end is right now. We only want to go to this point. We don't want to go beyond it. So we got the three new items. Okay, middle point against. Okay. In the cache in the vertices. Ooh, we want both. That's actually another thing as well. Reserve. They're going to double each time. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to like update the middle, the cache. And the vertices directly. Middle point. Point one. Point two. These are the indices. Explicit. Then we got a this map. We'll check the cache. it's not the end, then we found it. We can just return search iterator. First or second node? This will be second node. Otherwise, we need to try it the other way. Where it's index 2 and index 1 instead. Gotta check both ways. If we can't find it at this point, then we need to generate new point. So. Can I just... Yeah, okay, that works. New index will be whatever the size of vertices is right now. Like that. Otherwise, start in place back, middle. Middle point cache. Not point one, index one. New index. So we'll return the new index. So we put it to the vertices, we add it to the cache, we return it. Moving back down here. That means we need to add the three new vertices, A, C. Yeah, okay. It's the same pattern as we got going on here. So. In place back as what? V1, V2, V3. Okay, yeah. X. Then we have the new points of A and C. Actually, that's true. I could just in place back like this. What am I doing with all this UVX stuff? Get out of here. Well, actually, I don't know if that'll even compile. Try... was it Y? Y. D and an A. Those are the new faces we're adding on to the end. In line. Which is good. We don't actually have to reassign it. Like does in his. Okay. I guess we could just return the data. How do I return the data? Okay, we'll return both, basically. And then, like, what we're going to, because that just gives us the vertices and the faces. The vertices are, of course, all normalized. Did I even add it correctly? I didn't even. Normalize it. That looks a bit better. Anyways, that returns. Return those. Now we need to actually like get the position, normal, whatever data. So we get we got this. We got a bunch of data. We're going to pass it in. And then we'll put it into a templated type function. Start with one. Data out of this. It's kind of heavy to kind of come through this multiple times, really. But it's generated. It's again like a function that we run like once, twice, three times, very rarely, being the point. Similar idea. Switch between P components. How on earth did they get to that? Cube. Nope. But kind of. Okay, we'll just use it anyways. Position normal. Colors, something we don't have again. We'll grab that from here. Like that. Right, position and normal will basically be, because it's the same type, literally the same data. Position normal, like yeah, they're yeah. Okay, break out of that. Not sure how to do UV actually, or tangent, or bitangent for that matter. Okay, I don't think there's anything in here for UV points. Okay. Going to have to break out. So B, okay. Circle, got pi, UV coordinates, kind of like following an UV sphere as it goes around. So we kind of start like if. Okay. Try this. So we need to divide by pi. Okay. You give it to me, but then you t say it doesn't exist. Are you? Yeah, okay. Use the X, V is the Y. Okay. Normalize it. Tangent, yes. X and based on the Z. Because the Y is, or the V is based entirely on the Y, so at the U, which is kind of the X and Z based, depending on how far along it is. It'll have to times it by pi over pi. And cosine. Or a cos. Okay. Okay, and then okay, I need to calculate the tangent and the y tangent. Put it up here. Based on the normal, of course. The other cross product is based on the y, x, yeah, no, z and y. What is it? Yeah. Okay, so those are the tangents. Same thing, basically, but tangent. Cross product of normal times calculate tangent of the normal. Normalize it. Like that. That's how we get what we need. Okay. So this point auto, I need to put in a Same deal for bi-tangent.
Okay.
All right. Okay, we'll do indice data then now. After we, of course, actually put this in, I don't want to make the same mistake again. Yes, wonderful. It's float based and it takes in recursion and just takes it all in. Great. Really, how's. Const. Nearly 2 hours. Pi is not available. Let's see. C math pi. I'm going to. I'm going to guess like someone doesn't actually use this. It's non-standard. Is extension? Is it part of the extension area? Yes. Okay. So what we got? This is going to be actually pretty terrible because. In order to actually calculate the number of. Well, no, because it's based on the number of. Oh, no, because of the cache. No, I can still calculate it correctly. So it'll be vertices 12 times what? Every time it goes from 1 to 4. So you times it by 4 every time. This is like a. Yes, there we go. Okay, same kind of deal here. Starts off at 20, and then we times it by 4. Wait, would it be times 4? No, it's vertex count times 2. Okay, times 2. Faces is times 4. At least I'm pretty sure. Okay, for each of these, we gotta go. So much the cube. IcoSphere times recursion. Then we're going to have to just go through and add the indices, basically. Or these are faces. These are faces. Which I don't even use here. Okay, yeah. For each face, we go through. Z. Okay, and that's basically it. And let's look at the errors. That is wrong. Okay, it'll be a runtime error then. Let's see what we can do. IcoSphere. Let's go with one recur level of recur. Let's just say int. Okay. Let's actually start with zero. Aha! It is wrong. Excellent. Where though? What? We'll go inside. What we got? We've got vertex count of 12. We don't, so we return 12. So 12 times that equals that. Fantastic. It's in here that it dies. Great. So we got... Oh, yeah, of course. I'm still using the wrong... Ah, yes, of course. First of all, is recursion level. Now, if I had this like together in an importer of some sort, yeah, this would have been a bit easier to deal with. Still screwing up. Fantastic. Get in there. Get in there. Okay, we have vertices. We have 12 of them. We have 20 faces, right? I presume. Great. We're going through here, we're doing two of these, UV, that's great. Okay. So here, we're good. So it's on the indices that's dying, is it? Okay. Interesting. Okay, what we got? Index data of 20, okay. So we got how many faces? Got 20 faces. 20 faces times 3, you idiot. Face count. Right. Oh yeah, it's just, sorry, what? It's just a really crappy sphere with only 20 faces. Okay. Good. Ish. Let's increase the recursion level to 1. Let's see how spherical it gets. Excellent. It's screwed up. So I'm not quite in the correct here. Okay, so I got that right. Let's see on which one it dies. Does it die on the first one or the second one? Okay, dies in here. So let's go inside. Let's go into here and see what this comes out with, shall we? So we've got 80, which is the correct number of faces. It's the faces times 4, and we got what? 42 vertices. Forty-two is definitely not times 2. In fact, from 12 to 40, that's plus 30. Okay. For one thing, we can actually clear these out. Do 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 do. Minor, but it works. Right, it's all good. Good. This has to stay because of the GLM. Vec 3 within the normalize, I should say, specifically. We have 3 vertices, and we're adding 3 more. We're doubling the number of vertices each time for each triangle. But obviously not. The faces... Actually, what does the faces look like? If we go by times 2, does the faces at least work as I suspect they do? Suspect, that is. So it goes from 20... to, because it's times 2, right? Times 4. So it went to 80. So it goes into 162. Oh no, that's vertices, right? 320. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, yeah. Okay, faces. So faces does work. Vertices turns into 162. Okay, so what was the difference? Plus 30, and then 162 was another, what, 120? So 30, and times that by 4. Okay. So, let me pause it while I grab a drink. Okay. So let me just... write this down so I actually got it right. So I went from 12 to something to what was it? 162. And then what was the second level? Or the first level, really? It is 42. So it was plus 30 for the first time, and it was plus 120. Second time, let's see what the third time goes for. If there is a pattern, I will use it. $582. Which is, was it 420? What? If it's 582, like that doesn't 582 minus 162, 420. I can't divide that by 120 because it turns out to be something completely weird, 3.5 times. So it jumped 4 times and 3.5 times, then it's probably something else. Okay, I cannot rely on this. I can't calculate this. Or I can't, probably can, but I'm not smart enough to figure out the correlation here. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cheat. I'm just going to be that return this, and then return vertices.size. Thank you very much. I'll just do the same thing for this, just to be super careful. Okay. Doesn't even matter. I screwed it up. Oh yeah, faces times 3. Well, that is an interesting looking sphere, to say the least. I actually kind of like it. But it's not the sphere I was looking for. Okay. Closer look at... when he adds a new triangle, or adding a new vertex, what does he do specifically? He gives a length. Divides it by the length. Okay, pretty sure that's the same thing. Okay, let's just humor him. Let's just do exactly what he does. just a case of something I'm just not mathematically capable of figuring out. Let's see. We'll just do do this, which is just a gen.3 of point that we're trying to add. Square root of okay. Nope. It's dot H, control H. That replace there. There. No. Okay. Nope, same thing. My sphere looks like shite. Don't know why. It's like got the internal one as well still. Is this because of my faces thing? Maybe. Okay, let's okay, I'm not even going to try to reserve because it goes crazy as it is. Faces in place, that, and faces 2 dot in place. The original one, try X. Oh, wait, hold on a second. Because I had the internal one, I need to replace it with the new one from outside, don't I? Yeah! Oh my god, I am the idiot. Because the old one is now no longer existing. I need to replace it with the new one. Replace it. Oh, wow. Yeah, there's your sphere with weird looking UV coordinates. I mean, it looks like a very nice sphere. Very high frame rate, even though I'm got a number of, okay, whatever. Yeah, something's definitely a bit wonky with the UV coordinates. But actually, it's kind of close to smooth otherwise, apart from this little thing here. Okay, I can probably get rid of this then. I can go back to normalize for these guys. Yes. Right. Yeah. Beautiful. Beautiful, simple sphere. Does he actually? Okay, let's see. This guy just put the code up with no copyright notice, no anything. Okay, so I'll just like. No, I can still. Oh, no, 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 no. I can still do it. I can still do it. I don't need to do this. I can still do faces dot reserve times it by 4, and then. No, 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 no. Then the triangle I'm on. Of this becomes whatever that is, shall we? Yeah, a little bit of savings. Yeah. A little bit better. A little bit of optimization. Okay. going to try to figure it out. Or just kind of, okay, I'll put up the IcoSphere code as it stands right now. Okay, let's see if that decides to crap out on Windows, and then I'll have to do it's 2.5 hours, so I kind of call it there unless there's issues. Next, I'll probably do a UV sphere or probably focus on something else, because I almost have the sphere coming out just fine as it is. I may not need the UV sphere made of cubes. I may just want to like fix whatever the hell this nonsense is with the UV. Instead. Nope, it's looking pretty solid. Just a few more. Come on, come on, come on. Windows is always so much slower. Okay, at least that gives us some generic models to work with to generate on the fly. Otherwise, and then it succeeded. Okay. I'll call it there. Cheers.